In this video from IT Free Training, I will look at offline domain join. Offline domain join allows you to join a computer to a domain without the need for the computer to contact a domain controller. This video shows a number of different ways offline domain join can be used to join computers to the domain. Offline domain join tends to suggest the networks need to be unavailable to be used. But some of the scenarios looked at can be used when the network is available. The end result is additional options for the network administrator when deploying new computers. In most cases, you will have a domain controller available to join a computer to the domain. In some cases, this may not be the case, and a tool like offline domain join can come in handy. If you were setting up a new office and the network had not been installed as yet, offline domain join would allow you to join these computers so they would be ready to operate on the domain as soon as the connection is established. Offline domain join is also useful for computers where the networking has not been installed yet. For example, if you are installing a virtual computer, often additional software will need to be installed which has the additional drivers for devices like networking. By using offline domain join, you can join the computer to the domain as soon as it has finished installing. In other words, before the device drivers for the networking have been installed. This saves you an extra reboot. This is useful if you need to get the virtual computer up as soon as possible. The next use of offline domain join is with automated installs of Windows 7. If you create an unattended file to install Windows with, you can use offline domain join with the unattended file. This means that the computer can automatically be added to the domain when the operating system is installed without a network connection being available. The next question is, could offline domain join be used when there is a network connection available? The answer, yes. There are two times when you may want to use it. If you consider a small network that has a read-only domain controller, a read-only domain controller has a read-only copy of the Active Directory database and cannot be used to add computers to the domain. The read-only domain controller will replicate changes from a writable domain controller and store these in a read-only database. Thus, the only way a change can be made using a read-only domain controller is for the read-only domain controller to pass the change onto a writable domain controller and then wait for the change to be replicated. If there is an outage, offline domain join can be used to join the computers to the domain. Keep in mind that the client will not be able to authenticate off the read-only domain controller until a replication has occurred with a writable domain controller. In some cases, this may be acceptable. For example, in a very secure environment, replication to a writable domain controller may be strictly controlled and happen very rarely. Using offline domain join, the computer accounts can be created ahead of time. Replication will still need to occur between the read-only domain controller and a writable domain controller. The advantage is that once the data has replicated to the read-only domain controller, the writable domain controller does not need to be available when the computer is added to the domain. The next use for offline domain join is when you want the person joining the computer to do so without the need for a username and password. In a previous video, I looked at allowing any user in the domain to add a computer to the domain using a pre-staged computer account. The benefit of offline domain join is that you can allow a non-administrator to add a computer to the domain without a username and password. Before doing this, remember that the text file that offline domain join creates contains sensitive information about the domain, and thus it should be protected. To put another way, the person that you are giving the offline domain file to should be trusted. To start using offline domain join, you first need to meet a number of requirements. The first one is that the client needs to be running Windows 7 or Windows Server 2008 R2. For the domain, offline domain join supports earlier domain controllers than Windows Server 2008 R2. By default, offline domain join will attempt to contact a Windows Server 2008 R2 domain controller. if you experience any problems, you can use the down-level switch. This will force offline domain join to use an earlier domain controller than Windows Server 2008 R2. Since offline domain join supports earlier domain controllers, you do not need to raise the domain or forest function levels in order to use offline domain join. The only requirement you will need to worry about using offline domain join is that offline domain join is being run on a computer that is running Windows 7 or Windows Server 2008 R2. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 R2 member server to look at how to use offline domain join. Offline domain join is a command line utility, so I will first open a command prompt from the start menu to execute the command. From the command prompt, run the command djoin with the following parameters. The first parameter is provision. This indicates that a new computer account is to be created in Active Directory. This computer account needs to be present in Active Directory before offline domain join can be used to join the computer to the domain. The next parameter is domain, followed by the domain name that the computer account is going to be created in. Following this is the machine parameter, followed by the computer name for the computer that is to be added to the domain. In this case, the computer name is WS2. The last parameter is save file, which allows a file name to be given where the offline domain join data will be saved. The command does not take too long to run. Once run, the computer account for WS2 will be created in Active Directory. If I now open Active Directory users and computers and navigate into computers, you will notice that the computer account for WS2 has been created. If I open the properties for the computer account WS2, notice that when I go to the operating system tab, none of the details have been filled in. Until I run djoin on the other computer, these details will remain blank. Now that the computer account has been created, I can now change to my client operating system. First of all, I will open Networking and Sharing Center from the Start menu. You can see here that no network cards are installed on this computer, and thus it is not connected to any networks. This computer could not normally be joined to a domain until a network card has been installed and configured. To add the computer to the domain, once again, I will use djoin from the command prompt. When opening the command prompt, make sure that it is opened with administrator rights. This time, when djoin is run, the first parameter will be request ODJ, rather than provision used last time. After this is the parameter load file, followed by the file name of the file saved previously. The file itself is quite small. In order to access the file on this computer, I have copied it to a floppy disk. I copied the file from the server to the floppy disk when you were not looking. The next parameter is Windows path, followed by the directory where Windows is located. You can enter in a path like C:\Windows, but since I am logged into the computer that I'm changing, I will enter in %winder%. This is an environment variable which will substitute the current Windows directory. The final parameter is local OS. This tells djoin that the computer to be joined to the domain is the local computer. Djoin does not take long to join the computer to the domain. Once complete, the computer needs to be restarted, so I will now restart the computer. This computer is now part of the domain and will be able to take part in the domain just like any other computer that was joined to the domain using an online domain controller. Once the computer has rebooted, from the login screen, I will be able to log in to the domain. Since there is no networking adapter installed on this computer, I will get an error message saying that no login servers are available, but you can see the computer is part of the domain. Well, that's it for offline domain join. Thanks for watching another video from IT Free Training. Please see our webpage or YouTube channel for more free videos for this and other courses. See you next time.